Hotel. This was about when Lay's clients got pissed. At the time the weather was ill clear. And it was a great, well in French it was a pissé booze up. That's right, everyone got totally buffet. And it was flirting continuously, and this is what this song is about. And birds and stupid, I don't know what it is. and le soleil shine sur les umbrella, as we speak. Beautiful sight. very much. So I have to go to more French piss-ups. Now, a song written by Rob Fairbairn, who was stated by Jim, I think, Jim Hayes, was... Rob Fairbairn, of course, wrote This Is Australia For Me, which he then sent to Willow. And he, of course, wrote G'day G'day. And he was written up in the Northern Daily Leader a couple of years back, as Ray Fairbanks. And they had a picture of him with Ray Fairbanks underneath. So even the well-known folks, you know, they can get it wrong sometimes. But we had officially known as Ray Fairbanks Jr. ever since. And Ray, I wrote this song, Black Fellas Having a Party. He wrote it out of Alice Springs. He was at Ayers Rock, I beg your pardon. It was at Ayers Rock. I understand he was doing the 3-week residency at the pub, which I understand is a CBE, a character building experience. Oh, well, that's very encouraging. Thank you very much. We might have to pop that on our next record. The next record is going to be called When the Going Gets Tough, Go and Get Stuffed. I was reminded of a couple of things during that song. One of the lyrics in that song go, we sing and dance, for South Australians like myself, we sing and dance till the night wears on. Sacred stories, ancient songs. Dance to the moon and the stars and the sun, rainbow, snake and carawong. Now, dance to the moon and the stars and the sun, rainbow, snake and carawong. Carawong? Carawong sounds a bit like a seed that you pop in the cake. I got the lyrics wrong one day, sing and dance till the night wears on, rainbow cake in Carawong. which cracked you up, and we had difficulty finishing the song. But later on, when we thought about those blackfellas out there at the creeks, hopping into the rainbow cake, wow, what a show, what a turn. Yeah, let's have a party. Yeah, got the rainbow cake? Yeah, no worries. All right, let's go. What a turn. Well, that's the other thing I wanted to say was I met a very distinguished looking Aboriginal gentleman at the West Tammany Leagues pub a couple of nights ago, and he introduced himself as Malcolm Champion from Sedunia, and I'd never met a champion Aboriginal. So as far as I'm concerned, I'm a black fella now. Black fella black. And I met Robert Champion, two black people from Sedunia. I've just wrapped up the name Champion as obviously I got it from the native people.
And it's dark, this is.
Pat Drummond.
Right. Is that 3:30 for Brett and Pat, Johnny? 3:00, is it? Right, we're out of here. So we'll have to excuse ourselves with this song, Brent Parlane and Pat Drummond coming up, so don't go back, we'll be right away. Pat Drummond is a little fella from who plays half forward flank for St Kilda in the AFL seconds, but he's got a bundle of talent, the little fella, and watch him go, he's a dynamo. And Brent Parlane, well, you know him, you love him, and you can't live without him. They will be on very shortly. We'll say goodbye with this one. We were going to try and slip and see you again sometime, but we have gone over time. Those gentlemen up very shortly. This is called 88K from Alice and the Truck Won't Start. We have bought, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, yeah, they're all right, but have they bought the CDs and tapes? Well, we've got them, and to steal a line from Jim, we don't want to put any pressure on, we almost have enough money for the baby's operation. Thank you, Jim Haynes. But we'll be over there, and Pat Haynes and Jim Drummond, come on, Arnie Gagan. Brent Drummond and Pat Parlane coming up, folks. Start the show. Ribbon, then we're going to grab the check and piss off, okay? That's just a little joke. That's just a little joke, really. Darling fiddle man hasn't heard these songs before. Isn't it funny how a fiddle player can play a song? He'll play this now and you'll imagine, I've sprung him now, you'll imagine that he's been playing this song for a long time and he'll have never heard it. Fiddle players have a magical, is the word I'm looking for, miraculous. They have a miracle ability to do that. Folks, this is a song I wrote for my wife called They'll Have to Drag Me Kicking and Screaming Down the Aisle. We got married this year, but not without a 10-year drag.
just take me as I am, then I'm the golden knocker. Eventually the power of love may conquer me, but they'll have to tie me to a tree. When they talk of wedding rings, that's when I run a mile. They'll have to drag me kicking and screaming down the aisle. Shocker, now so do they say, and brother, I agree. You gotta know what's right for you, and getting hitched is terribly wrong, wrong, wrong for me. Any talk of wedding bells, and that's when I run a mile. They'll have to drag me kicking and screaming down the aisle. I'm just making it up, running the things together, sounding like a kitchen music. I'm kicking and screaming, screaming and kicking. When it comes to marriage, I'm a big fat chicken. Drag me kicking and screaming down the aisle. Screaming and kicking, kicking and screaming. If you think I'm getting married, then you know you're dreaming. Drag me kicking and screaming down the aisle.
There you go. Those have that uncanny ability to make it sound like they know the song well. Well, it's because they're bloody good in his case. That's Marcus Holden.
Woo! Hey.
What do? You give a fiddle player a break and he gets out his Leary fiddle. Okay. So, folks, this is the HM fiddle, the heavy metal fiddle. So there you go, this and that. So let that be a little tip for young musicians here. Don't bunk up your fiddle player. Because anything can happen. I think we'll get time for two more, folks. So you've already seen Brent Parlane, known to his friends as Bert Parlane, or occasionally as Wolfhead Parlane. And before that, you saw Ten Yourself, and you're about to see Jim Haynes, followed by Grant Lewis. And, however, we haven't quite finished with you just yet. And, so obviously that was a visionary decision that we probably could do without the flapper, because the flapper is gone, so now we just have the homely hum of big freights moving down the Gunaganu Road. I sat there at we're staying in this tent. Got the tent pitched up there, just tink out of town in a panic. And I sat there last night and heard all the trucks going up and down, and thought of a song called Big Trucks Are Rolling Into Tamworth. And I do hope it turns into a song, but hey, I just wanted to share that with you. But we do have now truck song, and this is called the Boomeroo Flyer, and it's the name I saw on a truck in Melbourne, and I didn't know anything about it. But we made up a story about the Boomeroo Flyer, and that was it.
Kiwi.
Any key you like.
Thanks. Anyway, as long as it's
Yeah. In fact, this is damn hard.
All right.
Good luck.
Mr. and I live in a Chukaran every Friday night. I have to run it down to Melbourne. I start out in New Mercure. I make Shepparton by the fading light. I get another load in Seymour, then I'm hitting Calcalo. I'm in Campbellfield about midnight. And on the side of my truck it says, Boomeroo Flyer. When you ride in this truck, you don't ride any higher. And everyone on the road knows about the Boomeroo Flyer. When I'm on my run, I get a lot of time for thinking, like, where's this truck taking me to? I think of rolling on this road when I'm run out and old, and all the other things I wanna do. And when I see the sunrise from my cabin window, I can smile, 'cause I'm heading home to you. And on the side of my truck it says, Boomeroo Flyer. When you're riding this truck, you don't ride any higher. And everyone on the road knows about the Boomeroo Flyer. Stepson and a new wife and a brand new baby, and a mortgage I'll be paying off for life. But we're in our own home, and mostly now we're happy. I breathe easy and I sleep well at night. And when I'm out on the road and I turn for home again, I know it's all gonna work out in the end. And on the side of my truck it says, Boomeroo Flyer. When you ride in this truck, you don't ride any higher. And on the side of my truck it says, Boomeroo Flyer. When you ride in this truck, you don't ride any higher. And everyone along the road knows about the Boomeroo Flyer.
Did he do okay again?
Not too much attention, he's just the fiddle player, guys. Did you? Put your photo in the paper. So you're feeling pretty famous today. Was it the Northern Daily Leader or the Southern Weekly?
Australasian Post.
There's a joke there, but I can't think of it.
Thank you.
There's a joke there if I could think of one. Oh, remember that line? That could come in handy. Folks, we'll leave you with this one. Remember, Jim Haynes and Grant Lewis to come. And this is called If I Ever Get Old, Don't Let Me Know. And I'm sorry if you've heard this explanation before. It's a new song for us, but I have been explaining that I did write the song hoping that Slim Dusty would do it, because I thought, oh, this is a good idea for a song to pitch to Slim. Well, understandably, Slim, I'll be frank with you, just for you and me, don't let us go any further in the festival. I don't know if Slim heard it. I sent it to Rod, his producer. He won't mind me saying this. And, they didn't do it. Rod may have decided it wasn't quite Slim's way. And he was right, probably. So we're doing it, that's all. This band gets better.
That's right.
The longer it goes,
I
like it best when we really swing.
Swinging hard.
So do me a favor, one little thing. You can tell me if my guitar's too loud. You can tell me if I'm not pleasing the crowd.
She likes you.
You can tell me if my clothes don't fit.
If your clothes don't fit.
Or if my tempo speeds up a bit. But if I ever get old.
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 Sleep it slow, don't let me know.
Just let me keep singing. And doing my thing, even if I should forget what to sing, just play along with me, help me pretend. I know where the verses begin and end.
I'll just turn the page for you.
And if I ever grow weak,
if I ever grow weak,
too tired to speak,
too tired to speak,
just give me a kiss or a little pat on the cheek. If I ever grow old,
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 if I ever grow
old, sleeping slow, don't let me know.
Oh, Marcus. Cheeks,
mate.
My body works fine, except when it creaks. I've got a fine band, as good as you get. I'm not about to chuck it in yet.
Trick, trick.
If I ever go old,
if I ever go old,
if I ever go old,
if I ever go old. So don't let me know.
If I ever grow weak,
if I ever grow weak,
too tired to speak,
too tired to speak,
just give me a kiss on the head and a little pat on the cheek. If I ever grow old,
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 well, if I ever grow
old, sleeping slow, don't let me know.
Thanks to Mick on sound. Yeah. Thanks to Joe Campbell, Marcus Holden and Gary Carruthers. Folks, we're just going to stay on and do a couple with our mate. You know him, you love him, you can't live without him. Oh, the light's coming on for the merchandise, so we're going straight on. So, sorry, Mick. Must have to go on then.
Well, I'm whispering in the wind, this winter we've been in. My pony's busting through the crusted snow. And although he's blowing hard, he whinnies to the yard where the horse is milling close already know. From the tree line down to Jindabyne, it's well below tonight. It's time to stoke the fire when the snow is. Stoke the fire when the story's well and wide. When the blizzards all push on, ghosts come stand alone. Hear the sound of an eagle's beating wing. In a crystal world of white, the rhythm his flight sounds like the big blue sky is breathing in. From the tree line down to Jindabyne, it's well below tonight. It's time to stoke the fire when the snow is wearing white. You're alive when you can see breath and hold somebody tight. It's time to stoke the fire when the story's where and why. Where the big sky the snow, cabin smoke hangs low, and horses bunch where sunshine's making steam. Oh, it seems they understand we're all part of this land. The snowy winter's silent southern dream. Tree line down to Jindabyne, it's well below tonight. It's time to stoke the fire when the story's clear and wide. You're alive when you can see your breath and hold somebody tight. It's time to stoke the fire when the story. It's time to stoke the fire when the story's wearing white.
Is there any such thing as feral still around in those days? So, for those of you who did see our performance on the big stage at Gympie in front of 22,000 people, Marcus Holden wearing a hippie wig. It was a sight to behold.
It's embarrassing.
Yes, but only for you. It is a sad story of a bloke and his missus who watched a 60 Minutes expose on the Byron Bay lifestyle. That was actually on twice. They replayed it. And he was a very nice fellow. They lived in Pennant Hills in Sydney. His wife Cheryl went feral, and this is the sad resolving story. It has its ups and downs, but let's get it over with. soon as it was over, we got into a fight. Cheryl said alternative was the way to go. Well, the very next day she bought a sarong and a sheepskin jacket and a brand new bong. And before I knew it, we hit the road. Since Cheryl went feral, everything's weird, and all our friends have disappeared, cause she's shaved her head and I've grown a beard. Since Cheryl went feral. Well, it took us ages to hitch our way from Pennant Hills up to Byron Bay. If we left those kids at home, we'd have been alright. Cause living off the land is all very well, but the mung bean diet was giving me hell, and I had to put that wigwam up each night. See, Cheryl went feral, everything's crook, and all our food is now uncooked. I'd kill for a burger or a piece of chook. Since Cheryl went feral. Our little girl was called Norell. We had a little boy called Bruce as well, but now she's Crystal Flower. And he's Leaf. But Leaf's pretty happy since we left home. He hasn't seen a bath or a shower or a comb, and it's been 3 months, eh, since he brushed his teeth. Since Cheryl went feral, everything's changed, and I'm quite sure I've become deranged, cause I can't remember anyone's name since Cheryl went feral. In respect for Slim Dusty, we're going to do a big change. Story gets very sad now. Cheryl took a vow of celibacy, said she needed no input from me. Got a navel pierced and stared at it all day long. So I read the tarot with Leaf and Flower and dreamed about a nice cold shower while I waited for my turn on the bong. Since Cheryl went feral, everything's pierced. Rings through me nose and rings through me ears. I haven't been this pierced for years. Since Cheryl went feral. Change me tune as soon as we joined that big commune. Everyone took their clothes off straight away. Their cosmic philosophy appealed to me. Multiple serial polygamy. I think the feral lifestyle's here to stay. Since Cheryl went feral, there's a real traffic jam of naked women in our wigwam, and I'm pretty happy right where I am. Since Cheryl went feral, yeah, I'm pretty happy right where I am. Since Cheryl went feral.
Thank you.
Thank you. You shouldn't encourage us. Well, gee, I'm not just looking at the time. What time do we come on?
Doesn't matter.
Thank you, sir. Okay. Well, would you like one more love song?
Brilliant.
And so I didn't write like the man from Snowy River, you know, and all that stuff. It was a bit different. My inspiration came differently. There was movement in the Chook House. For word to pass around that the chook from Old Regretta got away and joined the wild bush turkeys. He weighed nearly 20 pounds. So all the chookmen gathered to the fray. All the tried and noted chookmen from the chook yards near and far had mustered in our chook house overnight. For the chookmen love hard riding where the wild bush turkeys are. And the stock chook clucks the battle with delight. There was Harrison who made his pole when Foghorn won the cup. An old man with his breast as white as snow. But few could ride beside him when he got his giblets up. He'd go wherever man and chook could go. Hey, and Clancy the overstuffed came down to lend a hand. No finer chookman in that sturdy troop. Never chook could throw him while a saddle girth would stand. He learned to ride while cleaning out the coop. And one was there, a bantam. A small and weedy beast, something like a pullet undersized. With a touch of Colonel Sanders, 7 secret herbs at least. Such as are by Mountain Chookman fried. He was hard and tough and wiry. Just the sort that won't say die. There was courage in the way he liked to roam. And he bore the badge of gameness in his bright and beady eye and the proud and lofty carriage of his comb. But still, so slight and paltry. One would doubt his power to stay, and the old man said that cock-a-doodle-doo. For a long and tiring gallop, lad, you better stop away. These hills are steep and lined with chicken poo. So he halted, sad and wistful. Only Clancy stood his friend. I think we better let him come, he said, chums. I'll warrant he'll be with us when he's wanted at the end, because both his chook and he are mountain breadcrumbs. He hails from Snowy River, down by Kosciuszko way, where the eggs are twice as big and twice as rough, where a chicken's bum strikes firelight from the eggshells as they lay. Where the chook that can sit down is good enough. And the Snowy River chickens lay their eggs both square and neat, so they won't roll down the giant hills between. I've seen full many chookmen since I first commenced me beat, but nowhere yet such chookmen have I seen. So we went. They found the turkeys by the big mimosa clump and they raced away toward the mountain snows. And the old man gave his orders. Boys, go at them from the rump. Now what you'll find there, only the parson knows. And Clancy, you must wheel them, only try to stay abreast. Ride boldly, lad. And never fear the spills, for never yet was chookman that could track under their nest if once they reached the shelter of those hills. So Clancy, you're over wheel them, he's riding on the wing. Where the best and boldest chookmen take their place. And he raced his stock chook past them, and he made the rangers ring with a chook whip as he met them beak to face. And they halted for a moment while he swung the lash and hobble. But they saw their well-loved free range full in view. And they raced beneath the chook whip with a sharp and sudden gobble. And off into the mountain scrub they flew. When they reached the mountain summit, even Clancy took a pullet. Might well have made the boldest spirit droop. The wild hop scrub grew thickly and the mountainside was full of wombat holes. One slipped in chicken soup. But the man from Snowy River let the chicken have its head. He swung his chook whip round and gave a squawk. And he raced off down the mountain like a torrent down its bed while the others took the long way round and walked. And they lost him for a moment where two mountain gullies met on a hillside, but a final glimpse unveils in a dim and distant valley. The wild turkeys racing yet, and the chook from Snowy River on their tails. And he ran them single-handed till their sides were white with foam. He filed like a chook hawk on their track till they halted, tired and feathered. And he turned their beaks for home. And alone and unassisted brought them back. His hardy mountain stock chook, he could scarcely raise a cluck. He was blood from beak to drumstick from that man. But his spirit was undaunted, and likewise was his pluck. For never yet was stock chook cock a van. And down by Kosciuszko, where the pine-clad ridges stuffed their torn and rugged battlements to the skies, where eggs as round as billiard balls go rolling down the bluff, and cubic ones bring tears to chickens' eyes, and where around the overflow the feathers sweep and sway in the breezes and the rolling plains are wide. Why, the chook from Snowy River is a franchised word today, and the wild bush turkeys, old Kentucky Fried.
Championships. Peter Howell on the double bass. The current holder of the Australian Marlin Fishing Championship. On the drums, Lawrence Nottie. the card holder of the Australian Toilet Seat Carving Championship. On the guitar, Matt Walker. Matt Walker, the current holder of the Australian Toilet Paper Carving Championship. Done with microscope. And myself, Broderick Smith, the... Who am I? I was Bert Newton before. I don't want to be Bert Newton anymore. I'll be somebody else. Richard Burton. No, don't be Richard Burton. Quite young, not quite young. I have hair. But he has hair. I don't know. He never takes his hat off. You always say, no, he never takes his hat off. How about James Bond movie in Tamworth? How about a James Bond movie in Tamworth? You could call it Muckraker. Welcome to Tamworth, Mr. Bond. Welcome to Tamworth, Mr. Bond.
How are you?
Well, I'm not eating. Thank you. We've only got beer, Mr. Bond. And damper. You can take that Italian sit off for a start. Put on these... Put on these moleskins and get over there. Okay. James Bond comes to Tamworth. I'd like to see that. I'd love to see that. I'd like to see that. Oh, yes, sorry, we've got CDs to sell. I forgot. When they say CDs, because I've been doing this business for a fair while, I naturally assume they mean cylinder discs, the little old round ones that Edison used to make. But no, they mean these little flat things called aluminium sandwiches, which are $30, and apparently in 10 years you play them and there's nothing on them at all. But you can... cut and polish a car with them. I use them for frisbees. I don't know about CDs. Don't know about any of that stuff. I think it's all a big... Uh-oh. I think it's a big con. The whole thing. I think they're trying to make us not buy pianolas. That's what it is. Well, totally lost the plot. What is it? Where are we? Earth. Right. Sell merchandise. Yes, what else have we got? We've got Glomish condom purses. We've got tea towels. We've got oven mitts. We've got pineapple slices. We're going the whole hog. I reckon if you're going to be an artist and you're going to sell merchandise, you've got to sell it. Sell anything. We've got wheelbarrows. We've got hammers. We've got everything you want. Did a deal with BBC Hardware. They put my name on all of their products. Sandpaper. Are we going to give this song right now? I'm carrying on a bit silly here. It's the heat, isn't it? We're going to give this song called Earth Rider by a fellow by the name of John Stewart. And thank you very, very much for coming along to see us. I'm going to hand you back to Mr. Champion. Champion by name, champion by nature. How about that, eh? And of course, he's the heir to the champion spark plug fortune.
Songs are all the same. I could laugh, I could cry, I could feel the pain. Good Earth Rider singing what his two good eyes can see. That across the hill from Placerville, the wind sure can feel free. Stinking concrete cities, well, I never do feel clean. The air is dirt and the latest dress, enough to make me mean. Good Earth Riders, look around, I think you'll all agree that from Placerville the wind sure can feel free. I'm alone, say take you from Placerville. Show can feel free. Yeah, across the hill from Placerville. Show calls to me.
Here's your uncle, ladies and gentlemen. Now that is some fancy footwork. This is Greek line dancing. He's not just a pretty voice. Folks, Brad Smith there, and he's got his CDs up the back and he's got his talent up the front. And that didn't mean anything, and you know what? When Brad speaks, I'm reminded of myself. I love his between song patter. He's quite like me, it seems. He bullshits on and just hopes the joke will fall out. And in Brad's case, conveniently, it nearly always does. Thank you, Brad Smith. The fiddle champion, the current fiddle champion, Nigel McLean, congratulations to him. The guitarist is about 23, Matt Walker. He's pretty hot for 23, isn't he? Matt Walker. He only looks young, so ladies, you're all a chance. You're all a chance with Matt, he's just young, but especially the younger girls there. He's got two kids under five, I've just been told, so... Cancel that order. I say cancel, in South Australia we say cancel. Cancel that, what I just said. Now, that was Brad Smith, folks. I'll come on shortly, then Jimmy Haynes, and then Brent Parlane, known to his mates as Bert, affectionately known as Bert or Buffhead Parlane. And so give us just, if you would, a few minutes, and we'll be back with some more what they loosely call entertainment. Don't go back, we'll be right away.
All on, and he is the star, so please go berserk for Greg Champion!
Thank you, Jim. That was Jim Haynes. Boy, Jimmy. I said Robert Smith. Brad Smith can wank on a bit. And then there's another one there, but as the week gets on, the wank gets a bit longer. If you'll pardon that expression here in a family venue. Now, Mick, would you just put a little of this vocal in there? This vocal in the fallback? Thanks. Folks, we're going to open with Cooey Motel. Have you heard that one yet? Not too many, that's good. Don't want you to be sick of it yet, but anyway. Anybody from Gilgandra or down that region? Not too many, right, let's get stuck into Gilgandra big time then, okay?
One, two... Yeah, very much there, punters. We sometimes have people just bowl in and jump up on stage with us out of the blue, and sometimes you can get lucky, and today Becky Cole just decided to jump up there, so welcome to Becky Cole. Beck, just come onto the mic there. I know you're a young lass and you're a bit shy, but just to fill us in on your morning, you've been dashing from here to there. What? How many, half a dozen gigs this morning?
17 this morning, Greg. Yes.
Right. As many as the Dennehy children.
Yes.
And just where have you been? And just run us through your schedule since you got up. And...
Well, I got a bit stuck. I was in the cavalcade and I was on my float, and we were sort of early in the cavalcade, and we came round again, joined on the end again, and kept going around. It was a hard cycle to get off, Greg. So
couple of laps.
Sorry, I'm late. Yeah.
Milking the crowd for all it was worth.
Yes.
And then after that, what, do you want to do perhaps a little lunch or check the makeup?
A bit of an in-store, you know.
A bit of an in-store, you in there?
Looking for shoes.
For what?
Shoes.
For shoes, I said for shearers.
Yes, looking for shears.
So if any shearers in the audience, you might be a bit of a chance today. Well, there you go, it's a busy social calendar for everybody at the festival, and that's got absolutely nothing to do with our next election, but just thought we'd have a chat, get to know the folks in the band. After a while, we'll talk to everybody here. But time's tight. So, I've got another song to do, strange enough. Now this one, which we do from time to time, is called Black Fellas Having a Party. And it's, as I've explained before, it's written by Rob Fairbairn, and he wrote it out of his rock when he was singing in the pub. I want to mention that I was in the West Tammany Leagues the other night, and an Aboriginal gentleman who looked rather handsome, he's in his 50s, distinguished looking Aboriginal fella, very black face, stopped me and he introduced himself as Malcolm Champion. So, and his grandson Robert Champion, first Aborigines I've ever come across with the name Champion. So as far as I'm concerned, I'm a black fella now. Yeah, I knew I had black blood and that just confirms it. Thank you. Just stay with us then. We'll be back. I just want to say that once in a lifetime a really beautiful song comes along, and until it does, we're going to do this one. It's a good joke. Folks, now a song from our next forthcoming album. This album, as I've mentioned, is called When the Going Gets Tough, Go and Get Stuffed. And, a song written from a woman's point of view. A song about, you know, all of experiences, gentlemen. You'll be watching... No, it's the other way around, right? The women will have experienced the... You'll be watching a country music act, and the girl, you ladies, you'll be falling for the singer, and husband or boyfriend will be getting jealous.
Now, it's happening here today, Greg.
Is it happening? Can you feel it? Can you feel it?
Down the back there.
Perhaps it is. And ladies, do you know what I mean? Does the boyfriend, does the hubby get a bit cranky? You know, you think James Gillard's fairly sexy, or you might think Kevin Bennett's, got a bit of gazunka about him. A little bit of that certain je ne sais quoi, that a couple of the smooth movers have, such as, if I was a fella, I'd go for Norman Murphy every time. So, if I was a fella, I put that wrongly. If I was single, is what I meant to say. If I was a fella. Touch of the Broad Smiths there, I think, in my patter. Anyway, I think you get the idea, and if you don't, I don't either. We're all equal.
Stetson hat and a voice so sweet and high.
Stop singing to really make this act really kick. And okay, it's getting a bit warm here. Oh, maybe it's the 2 o'clock Colin Buchanan show. I hope so. The crowd went wild and then they all left. Must be the 2 o'clock Bucko show. Okay, well, they're the Bucko, they're the infidels, but you people here, you are the true believers. You're the ones I really like. I didn't like those folks. Yeah, the poor people, yeah, the poor people. These people living, they're rich. Yeah. Let's go and trash their Mercedes afterwards. I'll bet you they've got a Mercedes four-wheel drive Land Rover. Just that minor exodus of people has left the situation where if you're up the back and you need a seat, there are a few down the front. And if you're down the front and you're not happy with it, there are a few seats up the back. And if the people in the middle would just like to wander around a bit, you're welcome to do that too. Folks, a song that's going to be on the next album. This song this song, it was released on a single a while back and it went crayon. This is a pro-marriage song I wrote to my wife-to-be called They'll Have to Drag Me Kicking and Screaming Down the Aisle. Thank you very much indeed. Look at the time. I've perhaps got time for two more. Okay. Crikey, we've only done three. Crikey. Yeah. That must have been very long songs. Well, I've just wanked on as usual. Let's do. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to do a little song about a horse in a paddock in Australia. A song about a paddock with a horse in it. The horse is a native horse. Not many horses are native to this country, but myself, like John Williamson, unless it's a native animal, I wouldn't sing about it. This, in this paddock there's a horse, there's a cockatoo and a ghost gum. The ghost gum's dead and the cockatoo's barely living. There's a sulfur-crested galah and a yellow-crested African hunting budgie, which is a native Australian animal. There's an echidna, and that's not very well either. It's quite a terrific little paddock, and it's somewhere out in the Mallee region of Victoria, as is everything in John Williamson's songs. And if it's good enough for John Williamson, it's good enough for me. Thanks very much. How about that? How lucky we've got to have in the band Becky Cole and Joe Campbell, folks. folks, still coming up today, Brent Parlane and Jim Haynes. So this is the place, this is the action centre, this is the centre of the universe, this is where it's all happening. This is the meat and potatoes of the gig here. This is where the gazumpa is. This has got the umphicality. So don't stray, stay at the pavilion. Obviously the heat's got me too. I'll invoke the Brod Smith clause, the heat's got me. But really it's just the sleep factor. I asked this earlier on, but the audience may have turned over. Who got no sleep at all last night? There we go. Who got 2 or 3 hours at best? There we go. Who got a good 8 hour solid sleep? Right, you are dud ragers. Don't you know a bloody festival when you trip over one? You are meant to stay out till 4 or 5. It's in the rule book. Anyway, perhaps you didn't. You got up around 1. But whatever you do, tonight's your last chance. And if you can't get stinking tonight, you are not trying. Anyway, we've got time for one more. Jim Haynes is coming up. And I'm just going to have to shuffle it along here. Here's a song we wrote called If I Ever Get Old, Don't Let Me Know. And I was hoping Slim Dusty would record this, but... I did. I wrote it, thinking it would suit... hoping it would suit Slim Dusty. But his producer just said, no, it's not happening. And I imagine his producer, Rod, listened to it and thought, just a bit too silly for our Slim. And I admit, it's got a very high silliness factor. And first of all, that's my cup of tea. So here we are doing it ourselves.
1, 2, 3.
Hey, everyone in this band.
Yes.
Want you to know.
What?
This band gets better the longer it goes.
Well, I'm good.
I like it. Swing, we really swing. So do me a favor, one little thing. You can tell me if my guitar's too loud.
Your guitar's too loud.
You can tell me if I'm not pleasing the crowd.
I'm not touching that.
You can tell me if my clothes don't fit.
Your clothes don't fit.
Who asked you? If my tempo speeds up a bit. But if I ever get old.
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 If I ever get
old. Sleepy and slow, don't let me know.
Don't tell me. Just let me keep singing and doing my thing.
Oh, is that what they call it?
Even if I should forget what to sing,
just for a change,
just play along with me and help me pretend I know where the verses begin and end. And if I ever go weak,
if I ever go weak,
too tired to speak,
too tired to speak,
just give me a kiss on the head. If I ever grow old,
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 if I ever grow
old, sleepy and slow, don't let me know.
Gary, Swanky. Still got bright eyes.
Oh, red eyes.
And rosy cheeks.
Rosy cheeks.
My body works fine, except for the creeps. I've got a fine band, as good as you get.
Now you're talking.
I'm not about to chuck it in yet.
Pity.
If I ever grow old.
If I ever go,
if I ever go,
oh, sing it slow,
don't let me know. Canada. If I ever grow weak,
if I ever grow weak,
too tired to speak,
too tired to speak,
just give me a kiss on the head. Joe Campbell, Marcus Holden, Gary Carruthers.
Great champion, ladies and gentlemen.
If you'll pardon the inconvenience, one has to go and do a couple of numbers with that dropkick, Colin Buchanan. But just time to slip in a couple of songs with old Hainsey boy. So, ladies and gentlemen, without any further fuss, you say something, Jim.
Is it okay if they stay up and sing a few with me? Yeah! Oh, well, let's do that. That's a compromise, isn't it? Okay, well, this is great, because Beck's got Liger Cup, so no, you'd rather watch Becky play it than watch me play it, wouldn't you? Yeah! Oh, thanks, you bastards. I know where my strengths are. Okay, this is a song we do the Okay, we're gonna start with a telephone song. This is a song I wrote when I was in Europe and I was on the end of a telephone and it was night time and the stars in the sky were different and there was no one around me that I loved. Thank you. But on the end of the telephone it was morning in Australia. And the sun was shining in the best place in the world, and there was somebody I loved on the end of the phone. Yeah. So I wrote a song. There was no alternative.
I'm over here, you're over there. It's sometimes more than I can bear. So I close my eyes.
And I dream I touch your lips with mine.
Feel Australian sunshine. Shine on me and I can be
home with you.
Thank you. This is good fun. It's a nice. Oh, thank you. The lady
all,
said it was beautiful.
All rich people, Jimmy.
She was referring. Right.
The rich people are leaving because they got the dough to go to the patient.
The Mercedes ones. So these are the Volvo drivers. You know the difference. You know, you're talking about that echidna going backwards into the hole.
No, I haven't mentioned it.
Well, that's blown that joke. Oh, no, no. I was just wondering if you knew the difference between a Volvo and an echidna.
What is that, Jim?
With the echidna, the pricks are on the outside. Sorry. Yeah. This.
There's a laugh there, but I'm not going near it. There's a laugh, there's a joke there, but I haven't thought of it.
Now what you do is you do a demographic, you find out the least owned car in the audience and you bag that one. That's what you do. We're gonna...
Okay.
This is a song Greg and I wrote together, so... Greg and I...
It was working perfectly, I just thought I'd fiddle.
So I wrote the good bits, and anything you think in this song that's a bit sus, Greg wrote that bit. Okay. It's called Hear the Curlew Calling, and it's about the beautiful inland plains of this great country. Here we go. Marcus, we're featuring Marcus Holden on this one. He's going to be a good player one day if he keeps it up.
Is lifting few hands in the air. It's cold in the morning. It is almost here. Dawn light is creeping across a rocky range. Shadows are shifting. Colors move and change. Hear the curlew calling. Smell the coming rain. See the vision splendid, sunrise on the plain. Wander west of the great dividing range. Roam in the land I love. Nothing moves but me, only to seek the shelter of a Kwandong tree. As the sun that crumbles mountains does its work with time, in the faded blue stillness of a winter sky. Splendid sunrise on the plain. Wander west of the great dividing range. Roam in the land I love. Darkness is falling. Descending as the day is in retreat. Coolness is spreading like a ghost among the grass, whispering the secrets of the present to the past. Hear the curlew calling, smell the coming rain, see the vision splendid, sunset on the plain. Wander west of the great dividing range, roaming the land I love. Wander west of the great dividing range, roaming the
version of Wagga Wagga. We sang it on the track as we went many miles down Peel Street, which is a street in Tamworth that is 18 miles long when you're in the parade. And it goes like this.
You don't call Wagga Wagga Wagga, and you don't call Wagga Wagga Wagga, and you don't call
improvement.
That's terrible. Will do, Cheryl. The lady from Sussex Inlet is hanging out for sure. Well, but first, no, but first. Okay, well, we got all the Cheryls are in today. All the Cheryls. Hand up the Cheryls. Hand up anyone who knows a Cheryl, lives in the street with a Cheryl, who ever was a Cheryl in a past life. Okay, we're going to do it, but not now. This is a
what's not in my heart, not missing you.
Missing you.
You're not on my mind.
On my mind.
You're not in my arms, and I'm not missing all I left behind in my dreams.
In my dreams.
I'm not kissing you.
Kissing you.
And I wrote this note to say, not missing you.
Missing you.
You're not on my mind.
On my mind.
You're not in my arms, and I'm not missing all I left behind in my dreams.
In my dreams.
I'm not kissing you.
Kissing you.
And I wrote this note to say, not missing you.
Could we wish Greg Champion a happy birthday?
It's Greggy's birthday.
Happy birthday, Greg. Oh,
happy birthday.
Well, there you are. Well, 25 isn't a significant age in your life. So it's a special day. But look, it's hard to remember it when there's so much going on at the festival, but it's good to have it at the festival each year because you share it with friends. There's a party going on anyway, you don't have to chuck one. I hope it's an omen tonight because Jim and I are in the golden trinkets, in with a little chance. for the...
A very little chance.
For Wagga 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 Wagga. And if we pull it off, what a fluke it will be.
Get your money on now.
But it's a bit sticky because it's kind of like Rosemary Ray to get it too, because well, she wasn't in Best Female Vocal Nominations, and because she's great and because that song obviously has got a lot of appeal. But if she does, so if we do get it, I'll just be a little bit worried for Rosemary, and if we don't get it, I'll be going whoops. Folks, I hand you to Jim Haynes. Thank you very much for your attention. Remember, Brent Parlane coming. Don't go anywhere. Jimmy.
Thank you. Richard, thank you. Great champion. Gary Swanky Carruthers. And there were two others here too. Joe Campbell and Becky Cole.
This one? And let's all sing. I just want to sing Happy Birthday to Greg in the way that I heard it at Lisanne's restaurant. There's a nice little three-piece band down there one day, and my wife's Marvel was having a birthday, so they did a little thing, and every song that they played had this rhythm to it. So they sang Happy Birthday like this, and it was lovely. And it's Gregory, all right? That gets the rhythm nicely. Cha-cha-cha, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Gregory. Happy birthday to you. Why don't we do our little Christmas song? That's not your microphone. Yeah, you can use Bill Arts. He hasn't been doing anything from miming. No, wait a second. We're good mates. We're good. Hello. Greg, what can he do? We do Santa Claus has got a new truck.
Yeah. Any key you want to. Because
Tonight. Is that a Queensland key? All right. He's from Fremantle. So I'm sorry about all this mucking around, but this is impromptu in case you didn't pick it up. Our Christmas album contains such notable songs as you, Santa Claus has got a new truck, Deck the Shed with Bits of Waffle, Frosty the Yobbo, Robert the Rampantly Bogan Red-Nosed Reindeer, and many others. Well, not many others, but we had to put it on there because it was one of those scabby TV special sort of albums.
And many more.
Well, you better take care, cross at the light. Since Santa sees you coming, it'll be good night, cos Santa Claus has got a new truck.
He's hotted it up, painted it red, then he's cruising round town like a petrol head, cause Santa Claus has got a new truck.
And he's shaking, his hands are getting shaky, his eyesight's up the creek. I saw him knock a reindeer over just the other week. I'll have it covered in lights and presents in the back, but he got his license in a week, bitch back. Santa Claus has got a new truck.
And call him at home, but he's never there. Spends a whole week in that auto care, cause Santa Claus has got a new truck. He bought it in a car yard, he paid for it with cash, and every time he takes it out, he has another almighty stack up.
So you never got your heart, keep your eyes peeled. Santa's a menace when he's at the wheel, cause Santa Claus has got a new Santa Claus.
Yes, Santa's truck.
He's got a new truck. We must try that unrehearsed. hey, why don't we... weren't the band great on that one, Greg?
Oh, the band...
Hey, crook.
Well, I say less is more, but less is less sometimes.
Yeah, less is just plain less. Why don't we do a great... this is the one that's got the Aussie Christmas ball rolling.
This, in fact, I think, Colin won Aussie Christmas Boogie Woogie Song of the Year in 1933, didn't it?
That's a Gallagher songwriting award.
This won the Golden Sleigh Bell, I think.
Yeah, they know. I told the band, they know what's going on. Dashing through the bush in a rusty Holden ute, kicking up the dust, Esky in the boot, Colby by my side, singing Christmas songs. It's summertime and I am in my singlet shorts and thongs. Oh, jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Christmas in Australia on a scorching summer day. Jingle bells, do you want me to run it down through Christmas time? It's new. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a rusty Holden ute. Engine's getting hot, you know.
Dodge the kangaroo.
You know the song.
Sweating past the board. He's welcome too.
All the family's there.
Family is there.
Sitting by the pool. Christmas Day the Aussie way.
Christmas Day the Aussie
by
way.
By the barbecue.
By the...
Well... Ah, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Christmas in Australia on a scorching summer day. Jingle bells, jingle bells, Christmas time is due. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a rusty Holden. Here's a solo. Afternoon. Grandpa has a doze. The kids and Uncle Bruce are swimming in their clothes. The tide comes round to go. We take a family snap, then pack the car and all shoot through before the washing up. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Christmas in Australia on a scorching summer night. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, Christmas time is new. Oh, what fun. Not only enough to mount, only enough to make irreparable damage. Is Jane around? Yes, they took her to greener pastures. Well, why don't we do one anyway? Sans Jane.
Yeah, well, let's do one of Jane's big hits. Let's do Life in a Small Town, I think. Well, what did you have in mind?
I had something in mind at the band you. call me old-fashioned. When it rains, we'll do that together and we'll power into it. And if Jane does happen to turn up, you missed out, sister.
In your heart, boy, never let you go.